Do not try what you're about to see at home. You will fuck up and get bit. Hey guys, the Pro Rancher here, and today I've got a special video for you guys, how to skin a rattlesnake. As you can see, I got myself a decent sized snake here. It's not too big, but yeah, it's good enough for this video. So anyway, I'm going to go through the whole process of actually killing it and skinning it for you guys. So one thing I want to say is for you guys to definitely not be doing what I'm doing right now at home, unless you are a professional like me. I've been handling snakes my entire life, so I'm very comfortable with them. This does not make me nervous at all. Some of you guys probably would be scared to death to even go near a harmless snake, let alone one that could kill you. So anyway, let's get started. Okay, so as you can see, I've safely removed the head. Now, one thing to keep in mind, you guys, if you do end up killing a rattlesnake, you take his head off, do not pick up the head. As you can see, it is still very much capable of inflicting damage. All of the venom sacs are actually in its head, so he can very much bite you and very much kill you at this point. So do not pick up the head. And it's best to dispose of the head in a way such as burying it. That way your dog or something doesn't pick it up and eat it, or someone doesn't step on it, because yeah, no one wants to get bit by one of these guys. Okay, so the best way to skin a snake, in my opinion, is to use a pair of scissors, some good sharp scissors. Basically what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the scissors to cut right down the middle of the belly, all the way down. And as you'll see, it's very, very simple to do. And I like to start from the vent down below. Just find it's a little bit easier to work. Oh yeah, and by the way, they still move after they're dead. As long as you got the head removed, you're okay though. So I'm just going right up the middle. And yeah, there's gonna be stuff coming out, as you would expect. Skinning any kind of animal. I'm trying to make a nice, clean, straight cut. It'll make whatever you're doing with the snake skin afterwards a lot nicer and easier to use. Whether you're mounting it on a board or getting it ready to be mounted on an actual form, you know, for taxidermy. For this, I'm going to show you guys how to tan the skin, and I'll do that in a separate video. And then after that's done, I'll make a video on just how to simply mount it on a board. And I'll show you guys a quick example of that in a minute here, once I finish this. Okay, so I got it all the way up. Now, here's the easy part. Skin comes right off. Just ignore the fact that it's squirming in your hands. It's gonna do that for a while. Alright, so that's it. Now you just simply peel it down. Oop. Sorry, I got out of screen there. See, I'm just peeling it. Comes right off. But you gotta stop right here because I didn't go all the way down to the tail. Remember, I just opened it at the vent. So now I gotta continue from the vent up to the tail. And since this is beyond the body cavity, it's slightly harder, but not too much. I'm gonna take it right up to the tail. And then just carefully peel it. You may have to get a knife to initialize because you don't want to tear the skin right here.
guts is really the hardest part of the whole thing. Just being very careful not to tear the skin. So I'm not pulling very hard, just enough to separate it. Just a little bit at a time. That is it. Try to get it as much as possible. And then you just simply cut the meat. Separate it off. And there you have it. That's how you skin a rattlesnake. And obviously the same process can be used for any kind of snake. Just be sure when you're handling any snakes at all that you know what kind of snake it is and whether it's poisonous or not, or venomous. Because the last thing you want to do is end up in the hospital or dead from a snake bite.
Okay, so here's an example of what you can do with these skins once they've been properly tanned. You can see here I've got a skin that's stretched out on a board. I just took some old barn wood, and that made a nice kind of a presentation. You know, something to hang on your wall as a trophy. And then I took this one, I just found a piece of wood just laying around the ranch, a piece of old fence post or something, and just kind of wrapped the skin around it for, you know, I don't know why. Just, it seemed cool at the time. Anyway, I'm going to do something similar to this with this skin after I go ahead and show you guys how to prep it and tan it and then get it mounted. So if you guys like this video, I really would appreciate a like, share, and favorite on this one. I pretty much risked my life to make this, so you know, I really appreciate that. And if you haven't subscribed, make sure you click that button, and I'll see you guys next time. Oh, and one more thing. Don't let that meat go to waste. That stuff's really good to eat. Cook it up just like you would a chicken. You know, you deep fry it or whatever you want to do. Rattlesnake is an excellent, excellent meal. And I'm going to go enjoy that right now for lunch.
Are you going to eat that?
It's real.